Hi friends, today I'm going to give you a brief introduction about microwaves. First of all, let me tell you what and all I have included in this section. So first of all, I have written about the frequency, and here I have written the application, and here comes the advantages and here comes the disadvantages. So first of all, you should remember its frequency range. That is, microwaves are electromagnetic waves with frequency 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. Don't forget 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. Okay. Now, next point is they travel in straight lines. No medium is needed. I think you all know that. Just remember 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. You should not forget this, okay? Now, next comes the application. I hope you all know this. You can guess and write, okay? That is, one is wireless transmission, and I have mentioned radio, third telephone, and fourth heating applications like microwave oven, and many devices for drying materials and all, okay? Now, next comes the advantages. It have high bandwidth, okay? And the next thing is, this is not in order for you to remember easily. So I will tell in my order, okay? First of all, you should tell the bandwidth is high. Next, you can tell that the power is high and the gain is high. And, okay, improved directivity is also there. Four things. That is, bandwidth, power, gain, directivity. Okay, these four things are high, and the input, that is the power requirement, is very low. Okay, and the last thing is that fading effect. Since the microwave used to go in LOS propagation, fading effect is very low. Moreover, as they have higher frequency, we require only small antennas. Once again, four points, that is high bandwidth, high power, high gain, improved directivity. Okay, and after then you can say about the input power requirement is very low. And after that, two things I have told, that is, one is fading effect. Due to LOS propagation, fading effect is very low, and small size of the antenna is required. Okay, these are the advantages. And coming to the disadvantages, you can write in your exam, that is, attenuation, reflection, refraction, diffraction. These are the common disadvantages you face in all these signals and all. Okay, so coming to attenuation, it comes when the signals get disrupted by the birds and such things and all. Okay. And the second thing is reflection. I hope you know what is reflection. That is reflecting from a flat surface. Okay. And what is refraction? This refraction occurs in the atmosphere. Okay. Due to atmospheric properties and all. And the third thing is diffraction. It means splitting up. Okay. So these are the four points. Describe it a little bit. And these are the advantages. Remember the points in the way I used to tell you. Okay, it may help you. And the application I hope you know, and the microwave frequency range, that is 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. Okay, I am putting this full screen so that you can take a screenshot if you need. If this video was useful, please subscribe and press the bell icon button for getting more future videos. One more thing, if you're a final year EC student, please don't forget to subscribe. It will be very useful for you for your coming series and other exam and all. Okay, thank you.